Yo, what's up my YouTube family? This is the boy JC. What I got before you right now is a XPG Gammix S70 blade internal SSD that I saw on Amazon, and I think I had to pick it up to do a review on this thing. There are probably many videos online showing this product, but I want to do my version of it, alright? So, what this package comes? They said this internal SSD is a PCIe 4.0, which you know that's a 4th gen, which is required by PlayStation 5. You got a 3D NAND with an NVMe 1.4. You got an SLC caching, an advanced LDPC, and it comes with optional heatsink. That's a little thin piece right here, the XPG little thing you see right there on top of the internal. And one thing I'm impressed with this, on the box, it says it comes with a read speed of 7,400 megabits per second and a write speed of 6,400 megabits per second. But you already know, once you format it, and then when you format it in the PlayStation 5, the speeds could vary. So take it with a grain of salt. It's not everything that the advertiser says you're gonna get is what you're actually gonna receive once you do your format and everything. So let me go do the unboxing right now, show you what's inside this package. Just like a fun fact, the XPG is a brand from the Adata Technology Company. And Adata Technology Company, they make a lot of memory cards and internal and external memory cards. They're also a company that explores in robotics and electronics. And this company was founded in 2001 by the owner, Simon Chen. And the company is located in Taiwan. So this company, and they complain that it bricked after a few uses, like a few hours or days it didn't brick. and I believe they updated it. So I believe this is the updated one I have right here. So like I said, boom, this is a heat sink. I like this very much, very thin. I wish more heat sinks would be like this. Fast it does the transfer, and maybe in the next video I'll do a test where I upload a few games and to see how fast it uploads compared to other internet SSD that I have. So let me go see, look in my library and see the biggest game I have in terms of memory. Thanks for tuning in.